Tessa, the United Kingdom record holder, failed to qualify in Moscow in 1980. What a disaster she had there. And that's looking very good. Oh, it's just short of 70. And Tessa Sarnesen's opened with the big throw this time, not Fatima Whitbread. Tessa, a British record holder, has been over 70 metres, has performed well here.
Well, no one that watched the World Championships in Helsinki will forget what happened in the javelin on the last throw by this girl in front of a home crowd. It's a nice long rangy throw. It's gone winging out there, and that's a good throw. That may have taken the lead. Lilac has come back just as was suggested. It's turned it into a good competition. It's 69 meters exactly, 226.4, and Tessa Sarnesen still leads.
Fatima Whitbread, fifth round throw, needing more than 66 meters and 40 to go back into bronze medal, and I think she's done it. 67 meters and 14 centimeters, and that is marvelous throwing.
Well, Tessa Sarnesen walks out with a javelin, but she can hardly hold it. Tina Lilac has withdrawn from her final throw. She's got the winning throw in the bank, and she's got to take her final throw. And this is a girl who started her career, an international career, at 16 years of age. And for almost a decade, she's been in the headlines. And in the last couple of years, she's just been in the shadow of Fatima. But this is going to be her night tonight. Tessa Sarnesen, her sixth and final throw. And it wings its way out. It's been a lovely long series. It's not as far as her first, but who cares? She knows it, and we know it. The gold medal is hers, and that's history. Fatima the first to go over. And what a pair these have been for British field events, and for throwing in particular. A magnificent night here. A gold medal in a technically difficult event, a demanding event. The girl who put British javelin throwing on the map takes the gold in Los Angeles.